Now, meerkats have strong claws. Oh, that will help them protect themselves. These help them to dig out their underground homes. So here we learn a couple of things. They have claws. Claws are the nails on an animal's hand. So if you don't take care of those claws on your cat, they usually like to scratch on your furniture, right? Ours did. That's why we wouldn't let our cat inside the house. One of the reasons my mom would say, "Put Charlie outside." Well, those claws are very important for wild cats or wild animals. That's how they protect themselves. That's very important. So some families will actually declaw their pet's claws. They'll take the claws out. But if they do, they can never let that animal go outside because they're helpless.
That's right. They will not be able to defend themselves if they get attacked by other cats or dogs or monkeys or whatever. Now, remember, people don't have claws.
No.
We have nails or fingernails, whereas animals like meerkats have claws, and they use those claws again to dig out their homes. So if you remove dirt from the ground, you dig. Okay, so if you're going to build a house, you need to dig into the ground to build the foundation for your house, and they'll dig out their homes, which are underground. So this tells us that these animals live underground. They don't build nests in trees, for example.
No. So that's how they sort of hide themselves from other animals. They also use their underground homes and their claws to find tasty little insects in the dirt. So if they have really sharp claws, those nails on animals' paws, a hand on an animal, they use those sharp claws to then search for really good tasting insects. An insect can be anything from an ant to a fly, something like that. So they like to eat insects. In fact, I read they're insectivores. So they just usually feast or eat insects. That's what makes them happy.
Now, here's the next sentence. It says, no matter what they are doing, one or two meerkats always go to higher ground where they can keep an eye out for danger. So we've got a pattern here, no matter what. It means it doesn't matter what happens, they're still going to do this. So no matter what they're doing, if they're digging in the ground, if they're trying to find food, or if they're going to the bathroom or whatever, it doesn't matter what they're doing, there will always be one or two meerkats going to higher ground, which means a higher place because they want to keep an eye out for danger. And if you keep an eye out for something, that means you keep looking for something if it comes into view. So, for example, if you're driving your car on the freeway and you've got to go to the bathroom, you're going to keep your eye out for the exit or for a rest area so you can go to the bathroom.
Now, snakes, hawks, which is a type of bird, or even meerkats from other groups could attack at any time. So this sentence tells us there are some animals that really enjoy eating a meerkat. A snake, which is interesting because they have to swallow that meerkat whole, right? Well, they're pretty small, but that's a big animal to go inside a snake. A hawk, which is a bird with very sharp claws, they'll come down from the sky and grab an animal and take them up to the air.
It's kind of like an eagle, right?
Yeah, it sure is. Or even meerkats from other groups. If a meerkat is from another gang, they might even attack another meerkat. So you need to be in your own gang or it's dangerous.
Now, sometimes we talk about the different kinds of sounds that animals make. A cat will meow, meow, or a bird will chirp, something like that. And we usually describe dogs as barking, right? Bark, 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 bark. Well, it turns out that meerkats bark too. I guess their sound sounds kind of like a dog,
Very
right?
high pitch, so
That's right. So you have to watch one of the nature channels to hear exactly what they sound like. But one bark from one meerkat can warn the rest of the group of danger. So they might Be on the lookout for any kind of threat that is coming their way. So a threat is something that could harm them or damage them. Threat here is a noun. It's related to the verb form to threaten. To threaten somebody would be to say, if you don't do this, I'm going to kill you. That's to threaten somebody. Or what I just said is a threat. Well, here they're on the lookout for threats or any dangers or things that might cause them harm. And here the word threat is our word, power word for today. So let's take a closer look.
Word Power. Hi, and welcome to Word Power. Today's word is threat. Today we read that meerkats warn each other of any threat by barking. Threat is a noun and refers to a person or a thing that could be dangerous. For example, pollution is a threat to our planet, or terrorists are seen as a threat to peace in the world. As a verb, we say threaten. This means to say you will cause trouble for someone if they don't do what you want. For instance, Johnny threatened to hit Mark if he didn't do his homework for him. That's all the time we have for Word Power today. Thanks for listening.
Well, these are very brave animals because they're always ready to defend themselves and each other. In fact, remember we told you some meerkats would stand guard on higher ground? Well, those meerkats will actually stay there and protect the other meerkats, and sometimes they end up getting killed themselves. So they're very brave, and they often come to each other's rescue, meaning they help their fellow meerkats stay alive.
Now, they've got these strong family bonds. A bond is a connection, so your family might be close, so you have strong family bonds. And they also have this fearless attitude. The attitude, of course, refers to how you think about life. So they're fearless. They're not scared. So they have these family bonds or bonds to the group, and they have a strong attitude about protecting the group. So therefore, meerkats show that the smallest and weakest of creatures can survive in those difficult African grasslands. And to survive just means to keep on living.
Yeah, you stay alive even though there might be a lot of danger and harm around, and perhaps other people don't survive, they actually die. Okay, everybody, it's time for our Chinese teacher to explain a bit more, and then we'll be back to chat.